Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Coach Jones coming at you. I got another video that I think is going to be really beneficial for you. It's for glute training or glute activation. It's been a minute. I haven't really done a video in a while. I apologize for that, but I've been burying my head in books that relate to dysfunctional movement and core training and pelvic stability in general. And I just kind of needed some inspiration for what I can do for another video. And this one is from bits and pieces from a book from a lady whose last name is Elfenstein, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's Stability, Support, and Performance Movement. It's an amazing book. And this is, like I said, a combination of a few exercises. So we all know how to bridge to get the glute activated. But she also incorporates an adductor release, just in case people's knees are coming together and they're firing too much of their adductors. And it also involves some hip swivels. And the reason I'm doing this video is because I'm realizing now that the glutes are part of the core. And I think a lot of people will emphasize the transverse abdominals and some of the core stabilizers within the spine. But from what I've been reading, glutes are important. I mean, if the pelvis is what is going to connect our lower and our upper half, I mean, what's attached to the pelvis, the glutes are. And I knew glutes were important for explosiveness and for acceleration, for deceleration. I knew their importance. I just was not attributing them to core stability. And now I'm doing even more glute work with my athletes. So not only is it part of our beginning warm-up in regards to hip mobility, but they're also supersetting into glute work too. So this is what I call a bridge release swivel movement. And I'll start facing the back so you can kind of get a view of me, which is how I like to view my athletes. I want to kind of see a front view of them so I can see what their pelvises are doing and what their knees are doing. So actually, I'll start from the side here. What Elfenstein talks about is for the bridge movement, instead of just thrusting the hips up, because that's when people tend to kind of fire too much of their erectors, is thinking of a bridge as a string of pearls where you're just gradually lifting your hips up one pearl at a time or one vertebrae at a time, and it gets you into that posterior tilt to really help activate the glutes. So I'll tell them tuck the hips under. They're gonna slowly bridge up, driving through the heels. If I ask if people are having too much activation in their back or pain in the back, I'll tell them to feel their backs. Make sure they don't feel too kind of like hard lumps on each side of their body so their erectors aren't firing too much. So we get the glute max fired, and the next movement is an adductor release. So we wanna get the right adductor to lengthen a bit in case that's firing too much. So I tell them drive through the left heel to keep this left hip in extension and release that right adductor. Bring it back in, drive through the left heel so that left glute stays fired, left hip stays extended, release the left adductor, come back in, and then there's a hip swivel. So to drop the right, to swivel to the right, drop the left, or to swivel to the right, you're gonna drop the right, drive to the left, keep that left hip extended. We got a ton of glute activation, left hip, even it out. Now we're gonna drive to the right heel, keep that right hip extended to keep the right glute fired, swivel to the left, come back in, and then we lower back down, one pearl or one vertebrae at a time. So from the back, what I'm looking for is on the release, we don't want the whole body to release. We still wanna stabilize that left side. Just let the leg fall out a little bit so the groin muscles can lengthen, come back in. So we don't want a ton of knee movement or a bunch of shifting. Drive the left, right glute stays fired, release the left, and back in. And then on the swivel, we don't want a bunch of shifting. So I want to drive through my left, keep my knees straight ahead, and just drop the right hip, driving the left, even it out. Drive through the right heel, keep the right hip extended, keep that right glute fired, swivel to the left, back up and down. That was only two reps, my glutes are on fire, and I have my athletes do a set of 10. And I mean, I hear the whimpering by the time they get to maybe their third or fourth rep. But pelvic stability is important. I mean, if we're talking about lunging or patterns and the pelvis is jutting out to the side, and it's compensating that frontal plane. That's a sign of glute weaknesses. Any kind of you know, shifting or dropping. That's also the frontal plane. That's also going to be a sign of some glute weakness. And though that's more so glute need, the idea is to try to get my athletes' glutes fired as much as possible on lower body days, so they're getting less of some of the other muscles that tend to compensate, which are adductors, hamstrings, and obviously the low back. So this is what I call bridge release swivel. If you don't know that book by Elphinstein, pick it up. It's an amazing resource. And I post stuff like this on my Instagram, so if you're not following me, stop sleeping. You can find me at Jones_strength, or you can check my website out at CoachKimJones.com. See y'all next time.